Hi, Sir Beko Bin from Rappler. Sir, we have seen water cannoning in the Bajo de Basilog area, pero this seems to be much more aggressive, much more violent even. What does it tell you about the situation in Bajo de Basilog and China's intentions in the area?
Well, first of all, I would agree with you in your assessment that the Chinese Coast Guard now has elevated the tension and the level of their aggression as well towards the Philippine Coast Guard vessel. This is the first time that we can say that the Coast Guard vessel has been subjected to a direct water cannon with that kind of pressure that even resulted to structural damage of the Philippine Coast Guard. Now, if you're going to ask me how am I going to interpret it, for me, this is still a response of China perhaps on our David and Goliath narrative. Because since we started the transparency strategy, before the David and Goliath shows that we are the David and they are the Goliath. And on the story, it's David who was victorious in that kind of scenario. But since, if you're going to compare it last year and the recent incidents from the resupply mission in Ayung and Seoul and now here in Bajo de Masinloc with our humanitarian mission, it just goes to show that Goliath is becoming more Goliath. You know? They don't hesitate to use brute force to violate international law to show the international community that they are really going to blatantly disregard UNCLOS. But again, this is one of the objectives of the transparency strategy for us to be able to expose China in removing their mask of pretension that they are a responsible state, that they are willing to have a peaceful negotiation, that they are more engaged in dialogue. So this transparency strategy has allowed China to be agitated to show their real face now. So for us, this is still a victory of the transparency strategy. The mere fact that China no longer hesitates to show their real character of violating and being a bully country, that's still a plus point for us.
For the benefit of us here who are not mariners, ano po yung epekto ng pag-target ng China? Because we noticed na they were targeting the radar systems of the BFAR vessel. Like, what does that do if they actually destroy it?
Well, lahat ng tinatarget niya doon sa taas, puro yung antenna. Antenna yun ng radar niya, antenna yun ng radio communication niya. So, on the part of the Coast Guard, no, kaya nga sinasabi ko, ang Coast Guard, China Coast Guard yata, talagang hindi Coast Guard eh. Because on the part of the Coast Guard, you know, maritime safety is one of our core mandates. No? That's the global identity of what Coast Guard is in terms of maritime safety administration. So, those are the things that we inspect, no? And ensure na ang lahat ng barko pag umalis ng puerto may maayos na navigation equipment kasi ito yung mag-guide sa kanya pag umalis siya. And communication equipment, kung sakaling magkakaroon ng aberya sa karagatan, ay makakatawag siya. Ngayon, try to imagine you are in the middle of the sea and Chinese Coast Guard's intention is to destroy all your equipment na wala kang maayos na navigasyon, wala kang maayos na komunikasyon. So, this is the intention of the Chinese Coast Guard. For BFAR, not to have functioning navigation equipment and also to destroy their communication equipment capability as well.
Sir, good morning. Mikhail of Reuters. Sir, does China's actions yesterday constitute an armed attack on a Coast Guard vessel?
That's a very complicated question. But for us, we go back again to the definition of armed attack. Para sa atin, this is still not an armed attack because this remains to be the same. Ang difference lang naman, mula noon hanggang ngayon, ano bang bago? Water cannon. Water cannon pa rin naman ang ginagamit ng China. The only difference, perhaps, they are increasing the PSI, the pressure of the water. But as far as the Coast Guard is concerned, this is still not an armed attack.
In terms of next steps, what would you recommend, given that, as you mentioned, China is, you know, escalating its level of aggression against our own vessels? So what will be the ways forward on the part of the Coast Guard on our activities in Bajo de Masinloc?
Well, for the Philippine Coast Guard, we're just part of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea. Anything that concerns the operation or changes on our procedure has to be subjected to the approval of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea, which is chaired by General Eduardo Año as the National Security Advisor. After this operation, we're going to make a report from the Coast Guard to the National Task Force West Philippine Sea. And then, of course, it will be deliberated and evaluated kung ano talaga ang mga next response or next actions that we're going to take with this kind of action of China Coast Guard now that before it was just the Unaiza May or even the VFAR vessels that are subjected to water cannon. But this time around, Coast Guard vessels now are also being targeted. So definitely, we're going to include this in our report. As to the changes of the operational guidance, I'm still not authorized to discuss those kind of things because in the first place, as I said, we have yet to formalize this report and it's still subject to the deliberation of the National Task Force West Philippine Sea.
So again, was BRP Bagakay to the entrance of the shoreline? Is this the closest that we've had
since? It's approximately 600 yards. But it's not just the first time, no. The BFAR vessel came as close as 300 yards. So since the time of President Bongbong Marcos, we have already crossed the red line of Bajo de Masinloc. Before, during the previous administration, the government, these government vessels are always not crossing the 12 nautical mile mark of Bajo de Masinloc. But for President Bongbong Marcos, we have crossed that red line. We already did the 12, and then 10, 8, and then eventually almost less than 500 yards. We have already reached those locations. That's why the Filipino fishermen, yun ang talaga yung rendezvous point natin within the that kind of 500 yards in Bajo de Masinloc. That's how close our vessels now whenever we do patrol in Bajo de Masinloc.
So is the goal of the Philippines to eventually enter the shoal eventually? And what message will it tell China and the rest of the world if we're able to do so?
Right now, our guidance that we receive from the President in the National Task Force West Philippine Sea is to maintain rotational deployment to support the Filipino fishermen. Those are actions that are beyond my pay grade, so I won't respond to that.